Very good morning, one and all present here. It's great pleasure to meet you all again through webinar. Today's session, we are going to have a look into the library software, library management software. We can say it LMS, learning management software, or library management software. Open source, there are n number of open sources are available. We are going to see today Koha. So first, we will start with the LMS system. What is LMS systems? How it working and why the automation is needed? Then I will give the demonstration about the Koha. I will give you the links and I will show you how to import the data, how to enter the data, all those things. I will show you the demonstration. You can also go through at home. I will give you the demonstrations link, which is openly available. So you can use by yourself. You can explore whatever it is. Then the data will be deleted automatically. So it is easy for you to explore. So I will wait for another couple of minutes. Let others to join. Because today is the last session. And today we are going to have the practical, I mean, not practical, just orientation, hands-on training. And there are, I'm planning for two softwares. One is for the Koha, the other one is for the DSpace. But Koha itself, it takes more than 1 hour. But I don't know how I'm going to finish it fast. But still, I will finish completely for the Koha, the first one. Then if you have time, then I'll go for the DSpace. If not, I will send the details to you. And then I will give you the even demo links. We'll see later how it works. And end of the day, we will send you three things today. One is attendance, today's attendance, and feedback form. Feedback forms about the entire 5 days course, and you can give your open feedback, how it is and how was it, and whether it is useful or not, whether we have to improve or not, how we coordinated, all those things you can fill it up. And your details, you fill it properly because that is for the certificate purpose. So you can fill your main name and your positions and your institution name properly. So the same detail will be incorporated in your certificates. And end of the session, we will send you the online quiz. So this online quiz will be for 20 marks, 20 questions. It's all optional. So the link will be sent to you. The link will open only for 1 hour. So you all have to attend the online quiz. Based on that, we will issue the certificates and the grade. There is no grade, but still. Okay, we'll start, let them join. First, we will have a look about library management systems. We all know that what is library management systems and why we are using it. The main purpose of using this LMS systems to make the systems easy and automated to avoid the manual errors. First objective overview of library automation package, what other things are there, and discussing the basic requirements of library automation. Then explain the features of the library management systems. Okay, these are all, we all know that what is computer system. So when we talk about automation, we have to talk about even the computer systems. Sorry, some error, please. Sorry for the interruptions. Hope is my screen is visible. Any one of you can unmute and let me know the screen and my voice.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Fine. When we talk about automation, we have to touch the computer systems. When we talk about computer system, there are two units. One is physical unit. The second one is a logical unit. We all know that what is a physical unit. Physical unit in the sense of hardware, like a monitor, CPU, mouse, keyboard, whatever it is, the desk, each and everything will be comes under the hardware. The logical system is application or the software. Within the logical system, it is divided into two categories. One is system software, the other one is application software. So what is LMS comes? LMS is a application software, not the system software. So you know the difference, right? For the software, application and the system software. For example, the system software, we can say for JavaScript or whatever, those operating systems, those are all the system software. But for the application software, LMS management. This LMS management comes under the application software. This performs day-to-day library activities through the human interventions. Without a human interventions, it won't work. This LMS designed mainly for two major categories. One is housekeeping, the library housekeeping, and the information retrieval. In the sense of library housekeeping, it is starting from the circulation, the reservation, accusations, and even budgeting. You can make it through the automation software. So many things we are going to see what is it. And using to manage one or several library key functions, such as accusation, as we said. Accusation, many big libraries, mainly for the Western libraries, they always do the accusations through the systems. But many of the Indian libraries, frankly speaking, we are doing manual accusation systems. But the Western countries, each and everything through the automation software, even including requesting quotation, purchase order, approval, and receiving, each and everything they will do it through the online software or the library management software. Then the serial control, subscriptions. Maybe libraries, Indian libraries, we do the serial control, periodical sections through the library management software. And cataloging, as we said, bibliographic entries, mark format, AACR2 rules, all this will be integrated into the library management system. This is one kind of the function. Then the key option, OPAC, Online Public Access Catalog. This is the way you can communicate. There is some background noise. QCOM BTD. Can you please unmute your... Yes, thank you. So OPAC is the main platform. You can reach the patrons. You can give them the remote access for your library resources. They can check whether it is available or not, what is the status, how many books they borrowed, and how much the overdue fine. So their historical circulation history, everything they can check. And it should include, if you want to purchase the LMS systems, or if you are going to evaluate the library management systems, you have to check following operation functions are available or not. One is a mark format, machine readable catalog. The other one is AACR2, Anglo-American cataloging rules. Miss Catherine, you have raised your hand. Can you please unmute yourself and let me know what is it?
Digital Media Archive.
Hello.
Digital Media Archive.
Do you want to know what is it? Miss Catherine, do you want to know what is Digital Media Archives? Okay, let me go through this. And Z39, as we discussed last time, AACR2, Anglo-American Cataloging Rules. Dear participants, you are being requested to mute your mic. Participants, you are requested to mute your mic. Please, it is disturbing a lot. Okay, then AACR2, as we discussed 2 days back, Anglo-American Cataloging Rules, this also has to be integrated in the library management system. Then Z39.5, what is it Z39.5? It is a copy cataloging. You don't need to, I will show you when I give you the demonstration about Koha. This Z39 is a function of copying catalog from other resources. You don't need to enter any details. If you can buy ISBN, and you can pull out all the data from outside sources. This is called copy cataloging. For example, if you want to enter any textbook, you don't need to type author, title, publisher, many number of data. No need. You can find through this application Z39. This is add an option. Z39 copy cataloging. Once you search through this ISBN or something else, title, if you match, this is the title, you can directly pull all the details into your software. So this is called Z39, I'll show you. And digital media archives. Digital media archives is nothing but some of the library management systems, they will give along with the library management systems. You can save all the images, newspaper clippings, some of the PDF files, some of the articles, everything you can include into the library management systems. So this is called digital media archives. So these are all the main functions you have to check even when you evaluate. So you can do this way. In India, there are n number of library management systems are available. There are a few I have noted. And Allies, BASIS, Basis Plus, and Koha. Koha, it is open source platform. And Virtua, it is called VTLS. And Autolib, Libs is also, it is very famous. There are n number of online library management systems. You can go for it. And what are all the main checklist, functional checklist you have to check if you are going to buy or if you are going to evaluate anything? First, search capability. What are the options are provided? Then data entry with the editing options. You know, some of the library management systems, there is no editing options. Even what we have it in our library, we have the row one library software systems, which if I enter one accession number, I cannot delete. If I enter any pattern with their student's ID, I cannot delete. So these options, we have to check whether editing options are available or not. Then bibliographical interface software. You have to have all the bibliographical details. Then inventory control. For example, any reports, if you want to check, that has to be provided mainly for the stock verifications. This is called inventory control. And circulation, as usual, the check-in, check-out might be have, but still you can ask for more options for renewal, reservation, fine collections. So these are all the options you can ask them if it is not available. Then a fine collections. When you collect the fine, you have to give the receipt. So that print option should be enabled. Then budgeting. Budgeting, if you assign a budget in the library management systems, it will indicate when you reaching the budget. You can allot for different resources. For example, if you have 10 lakhs budget, books 5 lakhs, online database 3 lakhs, AV resources 1 lakhs, other miscellaneous 1 lakhs. You can just split likewise. Once you cross this 5 lakhs for the books, it will indicate you. You are reaching the budget, you are going to exit the budget. So likewise. So whenever you buy, when you do acquisition through this library management system, the budget will aligned and integrated. And reports, there are n number of reports library needs. Then yesterday I have shown then few reports that we needed. So those reports supposed to library management system has to provide. We have to check. Then stock verification. Nowadays, people, many people doing manual stock verification. If you have the LMS systems, you have to do it through the system. So that you have to make sure. Then backup option. Yeah, this is very essential. All the library management system has to provide a backup, auto backup. Even librarian, we should not forget to take a backup. If anything happens to the systems, we need a data. So each and every day system has to take automatic backup, not in that particular systems. The data has to be saved into the server or some other systems so that we can retrieve easily. So these are all the main checklist we have to check and we have to evaluate when you want to buy or implement. Then open source software. This is the cohort link. The link I have given, when you go through this link, there will be a download option. There is all the, what is it called? Materials are available. Installation and how to customize, how to generate the report. All the options are being provided. So this is what the LMS systems, the major functions and operations and the checklist. So this is our college Rowan software. If it is there, because we are already locked down. So now I am at home. So if I am there in office, I would have shown you the demo of the Rowan software. So we will be having cohort today. Then there are some materials available. The link I have shared. So this is the LMS system. So I have to go fast for the cohort. This PowerPoint presentation, I'll share it to you. Okay, before I go to the direct link, I will go to the presentation. Then I will show you. We will try to touch up Koha on DSpace, but Koha itself, it takes a long time. So that's why I'm a little bit fast. So library automation, we can do it in n number of ways. And the supporting softwares, Koha and DSpace. DSpace, it will be used for the digital repository. This is open source and n number of libraries are being using. So it is very easy. You can check with the community. They will help you out. Even for the Koha, there are many colleges and many universities are being used, even in India and abroad. The list I have shown last class. Even here at the end of the presentation, I have shown the list of Indian universities and list of world universities who are all using the Koha software. These two links for the demo, you don't need to installation, you don't need anything. These are all the customized demo software. If you go to the link, I'm also going to show you this link only. I will show you then the same way you can work out from home. Then if you have any doubt, you can come back and ask me how to do it and all. So you can check and you can check immediately the output. So what are all the library automation? You can do it. See, this is very common nowadays, self-check-in and self-checkout kiosk. When you see the big libraries, they may have the campus in different places, not in one places. So they will be giving the facilities to the users to return the book at any point of their campus. They don't need to visit the library. So this is the way they can do it. It is, there are different ways, the cost-wise. You can find the very established one or even the low-cost, low-priced items. It is available. So these are all the self-check-in kiosk and RFID. RFID, if you feel a little bit costly, then you can go for the magnetic strips. So magnetic strips, it will be little less cost comparably with RFID and RFID security gates. So when you put RFID tag, it is very easy for you to check the stock verification. And even for the selfing and checkout, I mean, even the reselfing. And when you take the scanner, handheld scanner, the RFID, the particular entire self, you can check what is available, what is missing. If you do it properly, RFID and the the location point, you can easily check the stock verification without error free. And mobile applications, you can nowadays give the mobile applications. Most of the softwares are having, but we have to enable. When you buy the software or when you want to customize the software, you please request them for the mobile applications. Because nowadays people are having smartphone, so they don't need to log into their laptop or systems at home. They can easily check their mobile. And LMS with all the possible modules. Acquisition, you can do it. Cataloging, yes, of course, without cataloging, we will not use. And circulation, serial control. This serial control will even has to help for the back volumes. Because once 1 year is gone, all the collections you have to post into the back volume. And budgeting and administration work, like all the invoices, quotation, budgeting, all those things comes under administration. Even for the clients, you can use for 5 to 6 staffs. You can do it SDI, selective dissemination of information. So when you use it through the LMS, it is very easy. For example, there are some students from the mathematics sections, you can easily combine with them the mathematical collections. Same for the current awareness services, new arrival list you can easily generate and you can easily share it to the users. There is some background. And MARC 21 format. Why we are talking about MARC? When we talk about LMS systems, it has to have a MARC format so that the data has to be incorporated properly and the output will be visible along with the AACR2 rules. I will show you some example when I am showing the demonstration. Koha. See, these are all the main book entry catalog, as I discussed before, necessary fields and the tags with an example. These are all the MARC format. 020, it is for the ISBN number. When you are entering into the MARC format in Koha, I will show you in immediate basis. And live whether classification number 080, 082 is for the DVA decimal classification, 080 for the universal decimal classification, 050 for the Library of Congress. Then for the author entry, main entry for the 100. Then 245 is for the title and 250 for the editorial statements. Then 260 for the publications. Then 300 for the physical descriptions and 520 for the any other summary. If you want to add anything, you can. And for the subject entries, subject ordered entries, if you want to add n number of subjects, go to 650 and add. And 942 is the mandatory field. There is the place you can type the media, whether it is book or any other material you can select. And this is the entry for the book. I will show you. This is the accession number. Okay, once you logged in, once after installation, I will share the installation process material, but I will directly go to the demonstrations once it is installed. This is your home page. Once you logged in, this is your home page. Home page will be appear like this. The major point, tools and Koha administrations. These two are the main things. As a system administrations or the, as a librarian who is going to handle has to know. And staff interface and OPAC, online public access catalog, user interface. There are two different interfaces. Once you have the login detail as a staff, these are all the main details we have to check. Under the tools, there is a patron, there is a catalog and additional tools for the calendars. Then administration, global system preference. Through this global preference system only, you are going to edit entire your website. And basic parameters, through basic parameters, you are going to define the library. And patrons, and circulation policy. Through this only you are going to show everything. Then the last one, additional parameters like Z39.50. This is called a copy catalog. And today we are going to see the demonstration about like Koha administration defining the libraries and pattern category like UG, PG, faculty members and research scholars, n number of types and cataloging. I'm going to show you two ways of entries. Two books I will show you how to entry manually and through the Z39 and circulation. I'm going to make the pattern and I'm going to show you the circulation. Then after all this, I'm going to show you the OPAC, how it will be reflect on the OPAC. So within this global system preference, these are all the main things we are going to touch. And OPAC, how we are going to modify the footer, how we are going to modify the left hand side and right hand side options. These are all the things I am going to show you. This is the link for the overall world who are using for the Koha. And Koha using libraries in Nigeria, because we have a Nigerian participants. And Koha using libraries in India. India comes under South Asia. Even Nigeria comes under Africa. So first you have to click by the continent, then you can go by the country wise. So this is the presentation and I'm going to give you the live demo now. Okay, hope you can see my screen. This is the Koha demo version. First, sure. I will show you. Yeah, thank you. The link I have given already in the first slide. This is the demo link. Anybody can use. See, these are all the Switzerland, some other language, France. You can use this USA one, so that it will be in English version. So this is the OPAC system. This is the staff interface. This is the username and password. They have given us a open data. We can do it by ourselves. I will first click OPAC, Online Public Access Catalog. See, this is the OPAC. I'm going to add few more things and I'm going to show you how it will be reflecting after modification. This is the OPAC. I'll click. This is the staff interface. So the password they have given, username password, I'll just copy. You can also use the same one. I'm login. See, they have given, this is somebody else. They have given as a public usage. See, this is the interface. Now what we are going to see. Now I'm going to first design the library name and pattern, and I'm going to show you the cataloging one or two books. After doing, I'm going to do the circulation. Then I'm going to go the OPAC system. Okay, first let me set the library. First, we have to set the library. For that, we have to go to the tools or Koha administration. I prefer you have to go to Koha administration. Once you got Koha administration, this is the entire options for the administration purpose. Here the one we are going to add, modify, edit, delete, anything. So first, global system preference. This I will come back later. Before that, basic parameters. First you have to design or the set the library. Go to set the library. See, already there are many people used. I am going to use now the new library. What name we can give today? Today morning I tried for Tyagaraja College of Preceptors. It is there already. So I'm going to use for the. Hello. Okay, Indian University. I will name it Indian University Library. Just for the demo purpose. INDU. I'll make it as a code. IND Indian University. Here I can say anything. Then I will show you how it works. Then email, if you want, you can give the detail and post address. Then URL, I will make it our college URL, Thyagarajar College of Preceptors. Later I will show you how it will be reflecting. Then whatever, you can give all the details like Madurai, Tamil Nadu, India. Okay, I have given, I'm going to set the library. Pick the location, yes or no, you can give submit. Now I set the library as a Indian University Library. Okay, now I added the library. See, if I click here, set the library. Why I'm saying there are so many branch libraries, you can comes under one umbrella. So that's why they have given a branch libraries. So here, see, there are n number of libraries. See, the Indian University Library, we just created. It is there, submit. See here, it is changed already. Now we are in Indian University Library. This is for us. Now we can modify anything under this college name, Indian University Library. Now we are in Indian University Library. See the address here, Indian University Library, Madurai, Tamil Nadu, TCP, everything is there. The detail. This will reflect in the Koha using libraries. Okay, now I set the library. Now what I have to do? Item type. So before I do, I will show you some types of items. Maybe you may have the books, periodical, AV resource, thesis. If you want to add anything else, dissertation, you can add simply. Add a new items. See the new items, you can choose anything that you want. You can add the image or no image. It is up to you. Already it is default. It is there. All the items like books, periodical, everything. Once done, now I am going to create the pattern. I design the library pattern category. Let me use the patterns. Ma'am Sasila, your mic is unmute. Okay, and now I'm going to make the pattern category because there are different types of pattern. Now I'm going to make the undergraduate UG. Because for undergraduate, we may issue 10 books. For postgraduate, we may issue more numbers like 15, 20. So we will split in the category. This is just for an example. We have to give in a month for the period. I will make it for maybe they study for 3 years, 36 months or the calendar year until when. Here you have to check the category type, whether they are adult or organizational professionals. I'll make it just adult. And for what library you are going to do? Indian University Library, which we have designed now. Here you have to check item dues. When you have item dues, you can send the reminders. Advance notice, 1 or 2 days before if you want, you can select and you can click the email options. And when you want to check out, check in, the email notification has to go to them. So these are all the options you have to check. Let me save. I saved as under the undergraduate students. This is the category. Now I'm going to create the pattern. How you are going to create the pattern? See it on the top, just pattern. You create as a single pattern. It is asking whether adult or what, whatever the category we created. I created undergraduate. Okay. Now I'm created. I'll put my name. Or I will put somebody else's name. Prapod Sharma. I don't know what exact name. I'm just giving Prapod Sharma. Anything else if you want, you can select. You have to check some mandatory field. Email IDs, you can check there. I will take it for my library email. The session going to be end within a minute. If it is disconnected, you can join back with the same ID. TCP library. Now I'm creating the pattern. Okay, everything I have done. The card number I have to check. TCP 002. Just TCP 002 I have selected. Undergraduate, if you want anything. When the expiry date, after 3 years you can make it. Because undergraduate, I will make it something. If you want to give any notes, you can do it. Then their username, password. I will do it like Prepot. Otherwise, I will make it demo. Otherwise, I will forget. Demo. Okay, thanks for joining back. Just let me finish this. I'll make it demo and demo so that I will not forget. Confirm password, demo. I check everything. I'm going to save. Let others to join, then I will share it. Okay, just save. I'm going to save the pattern detail. I saved TCP 002 as a user. Okay, now I have defined the library. Now I have defined the pattern. Now I'm going to enter. Thangaveli sir, are you there? There is something going on the screen. Let me stop and again I will share it. Maybe something. Okay, now I have a pattern. I have entered the library. I have entered the pattern category. Now I'm going to enter the books. I'm going to catalog. For example, if I want to add the photo, see, I have the pattern details here. I'm going to add the pattern. If you come down, you have all the details. Whatever I entered, everything is there. See, this is my check-in, check-out. This is my fine search, holding, restrictions. My account details, everything is there as a user. If I want to add the photo, just come back and just click. I'm going to choose the photo. Just upload. Yeah, see, the photo has been uploaded. So now we have all the options are available. Okay, now everything is done. Now again, I'm going back to the home page. Under home page screen. There is a catalog. Go to catalog. Here I'm going to enter. As I said, I'm going to enter manually as well as using Z39. This is the copy catalog. Let others to join. Maybe 28. Okay, I'll show you two options. One is manual entry, one is through the Z39. I will first go to the manual entry. Select a new record. Book and reference material. Let it load. This is manual entry. As I said, there are only few details we need to have. Necessary field. See, wherever it is showing the requirements, we have to enter. This full length control, you just click, the number will be taken automatically. just you click, the number will taken. See, the number is taken. These two things you have to do it manually. The first and foremost 020 is ISBN number. I will go to Amazon and I will take some books. See, I'll take some books. Think and Grow Rich, Napoleon Hill. I'm going to take the details of ISBN, all those things. I can take it from there. I take the ISBN. I'm going to use it. You remove this hyphen. Just ISBN always having 13 digits. You should know that 13 digits. Then 082 is a DV decimal classification. See, this is what the DV decimal classification number. First one is edition, whether 23 or anything. Here you type the classification number. For Think and Grow Rich, we can say it for the leadership. Or motivational, we can say it as a leadership. For leadership, 658.4092 is a leadership number. Then author is Napoleon Hill. We will make it as a HILL for the 3-digit cutter, HILL. Okay, then what we need, 100. Go on the top. See, here they have given 0, 1, 2. It means all 100. Go to 1. It is 100. 100 is for the main entry. Here I am going to enter the person name. What is person's name? Hill. Napoleon Hill. We have to type like Hill, comma Napoleon, right? I'm entering everything manually. Then 245. Go to 200. 245 is what? The title, main title. What is the title? Think Rich and Grow Rich. I entered. Then if you have that subtitle, you can enter it here. For example, I will make it subtitle if there is no subtitle, but I will add just for a sample. Subtitle, I will make it just a subtitle. Otherwise, leadership. I'm just entering manually, which is the detail is not available. Then after 245, 260. What is 260? Publisher's detail. If you have the place of publishers, Delhi, distributor, it is there already. You can check it from here. Yeah, the publisher is Amazon Readers. And date of publication 2015. So we have entered all the details. Then 300. Go to 300. What is it? The physical descriptions, number of pages and everything. I make it for 300 pages. If you want, you can make it size and everything. Then go to 600. You can check later what are all the other fields. 650 is for the keywords. Here you enter whatever the keywords that you want for this particular book. Motivation. If you want to make it duplicate, see the this one, repeat this tag. Click it. Down, if you see, it will be open. 630. See? Motivation. Leadership. I have no time. I have to go fast. Then I will make Sundar. I will add one more Sundar as a keyword. I will show you why I added. Then go to 940. This is 942 is for what? To select the type. See, they mentioned the requirement. You make it as a book. If you want any other resources, you can select here. That's it. Okay, now you have to go on the top, just save it. Whatever you save, this is all a record. You are making the record first. Now only you are coming to the item. You know the record means full book detail. Here only I am going to add the barcode number. See, here it is the barcode number. Once you click, automatically this will taken. But we change it manually. TCP, I want to give 0000 four digit, then I will start. One. This is the barcode number. See, where I have entered the call number, it came here. It is appeared automatically. Here is the date of purchase. I will make you today. Source, Amazon. Wherever, whatever the publishers, you can make it. And the price, cost for this book, I'll make it for 250 rupees. That's it. So these are all the main details I have to enter. Here, whatever the book title, it came already. Here, I have two options. Add item means this one number will be added, like TCP 00001. If you want to add multiple copies, for example, two copies, come here. You just add two. The second accession number, it will take automatically. Okay, just add. That's it. Now I'm done the requirement. See, two numbers are being added. See the barcode number 0102 taken automatically. See the full detail it has taken automatically. It is so easy. I entered now detail. I will go to opaque now. See, this is opaque. Just a refresh. Sometime it takes few minutes to save it into the server. Now I saved. Here I am checking Grow Rich, right? Here all library I mentioned, I have to select the particular Indian library. See, there are N number, Rich Grow, many things are there. I have to select my particular library, Indian University Library. Let me select. See, the title has come. This is what we entered. See, Think and Grow Rich, Leadership, Hill, Napoleon, everything is there. Come down. See the browse detail. It is showing available, self, university name. See, if I click this university, Indian University, it will take into my college ID because I have given my college email, right? See the number tcp.ac.in. Our college website takes little slow. Okay, so this is the way. So now you have everything. In opaque, it is reflecting. Okay, see the image will come automatically later. I will show you how it will be. It will be taking from the Amazon or Google, but it takes a little time. When I search after, it will be showing. Okay, now I have entered manually. Now again, I'm going to catalog. Now I'm going to take it from Z39. I'm going to click. You select all, see Library of Congress. These are all the other libraries. I'm going to pull the details. I'll go to Amazon. I will search some book. You all know that Rich Dad, Poor Dad. Okay. I'm going to take the ISBN number. That's why I'm taking this. See, this is the ISBN. I'm going to search from these libraries. I'm going to copy catalog. C39. You select all library and search. Are you guys are there? Yeah, 33 people.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, ma'am.
Sir, I don't understand G39. Can you repeat?
Yeah, I will repeat. This is what Z39 that I'm there already. I will close and I'll show you again. See this, before I made it manual entry, right? You all understand. Now I'm going to take it from some other place. I'm not going to enter anything. I will show you this 339 is a add-on option. It is already exists. These are these many universities. It is already integrated with the Koha. Now what you have to do, you have to check this rich dad, poor dad, this ISBN, whether these following libraries are having it or not. First, let me check. Then what I'm going to do, if these libraries having these books, I'm going to take the details from their catalog. I'm going to copy their catalog into my Koha. That's it. Before I entered manually, grow rich, think and grow rich, I entered manually. This rich dad and poor dad, I'm going to take the data from some other library.
Okay.
From this library. You got okay. it, ma'am?
Yeah.
I will show you. Yeah, I will show you, then you will understand. Yeah, see?
Okay.
Now I got the data from following libraries. See, Ohilo Link Library, and these libraries having this book. See, Rich Dad, Poor Dad, Kiyosaki, Robert, author, ISBN, everything is there. Now I have to decide which data I am going to import from this. Just I'm clicking import. See, it is automatically coming to my Koha. You can see the screen. I'm not doing anything.
Yeah.
I'm not entering. I didn't enter anything. See, the data has come. This 080. You can check the ISBN. 020 is ISBN. See the ISBN. It taken automatically. And go to 084 082 for the classification scheme, DV decimal classification. Only these you have to enter, because that library, they may follow different classification scheme, Library of Congress. So I have to enter manually here. I will take it like 658.4092 as a leadership. This Kiyosaki KIY, I will just take something KIY. I'm not doing anything, only I added this classification number. Go to 100. See, author Robert Kiyosaki, it is taken from somewhere. Author's date of birth, everything is taken from somewhere else, some other library. Then 245 is a title. See the title, Rich Dad and Poor Dad. This is all subtitle, is taken from the website. Then 260, publication, see the details. Scott is this. Plata publisher, year of publications, everything taken from the website directly. Then go to 300. What is 300? See the physical descriptions are there. Then go to 650 for the keywords. See finance and person, finance and personal, investment, many things are there, rich people. See, already keywords taken. Everything is taken from somewhere else. Now what I have to do, go to 945, the require field, just a book I have to select. Then I'm going to save the document, simply. See, now I have all the data. I don't enter anything. Here I have to enter the barcode. TCP 003. Yes, this I will add only one copy, just add number. If you want to add date of purchase, make it yesterday, an amount, 100, anything you can give. Just add record. See, now I added the record, one is manually, one is through this data. Now I'll go to the catalog, See, this is the search options. This is the search options. I'm going to check Grow Rich. Just I'll search Grow. This is within the staff interface. See, this is all for the other libraries. Because this is comes under different libraries, we have to select which is for the Indian University. Okay, I will go to OPAC and I will show you. I'm going to type Rich Dad and Poor Dad. Rich Dad by University, Indian University. Okay, now I entered the patron name, I entered a book. Now I'm going to issue the books. See, Rich Dad and Poor Dad. It taken all the books. See the image. I don't enter the image. It is taken automatically. Yeah. See the Indian University. The number what we have given. TCP003. So this is the book. So now I have everything. I'm going to issue the books. Right. Go to home. Check the circulation. Right. Now I'm going to check out the book. Check out what number. First we have to key in the barcode, right? TCP patron name. See the Prabhat Sarba TC. I mean this is the username. See the account all has come. Now I have to check the barcode. TCP 000, whether 2 or 3. I will issue 3. Just check out. Now the book is issued to the Prabhat, Dr. Prabhat. See the history, check out. Circulation history under the name of Sundar. See, this is my name. Checked out. This is the book issued, issue date, then a returning date. Everything is there. Now I have to go back, Rich Dad and Poor Dad. Again, I will check here. Before it shows available. Now I refresh here. Indian University. Same book I am checking again. See the status, checked out. Yeah, status changed. So now I have given, created the library name. I created the use patron category. I created one patron. I entered 2 books manually as well as through the Z39. Then I have shown you the circulation. Then OPAC also I have shown. How much easy it is. So we have to implement, we have to utilize. We have to save the money for the management. I mean, where you're working. As well as we'll be having self-satisfaction. I have implemented Koha. I know the software. Self-improvement. Yeah. So this is what, now I'm going to show one more thing. This is all done. Circulation, transaction, report, everything I have shown. Now I'm going to modify the OPAC page. See, this is the OPAC, right? This output, I want to change something. Let me open some other documents. I have some Koha setups with me. Now I'm going to modify the OPAC homepage. For where I have to go, Koha administration. Koha administration. Now I have to go the global system preference. Is my screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Now I'm going to OPAC. Go to OPAC. See, there are so many options. You can edit one by one. I will show you the main operations. Go to OPAC. See, this is what the first preference we have to change. When you go to OPAC, see the HTML footer. There are something we have to change the footer. Just a minute. For this, you have to know the small HTML code. Just a minute, please be patient. If I show you one or two things, it's enough. Oh my God, my system gets hanging. This Word file, I will share it to you later so that you'll be having it for the reference purpose. I'm searching some coding which I have it with me so that I can easily show you. Yeah, sorry for the interruptions. I will come back. Just a minute. See, wherever you find this click and edit options, you can change. OPAC main user block, just click. They have entered something. I'm going to just modify everything.
So, is it necessary to have Ubuntu
to use Goha?
Sorry?
Software? Sir, it is necessary to have Ubuntu software on laptop to use Goha?
No, I'm sorry. I didn't get you clearly. You are asking it is necessary something you are asking, but after that it is, the voice is getting break.
I mean, sir, to use Goha on one's personal computer, is it mandatory to use Ubuntu software or Windows?
Windows as well as the Linux, it will be working in both. That is what you are asking, right? Operating platform?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You can use it for Linux or Windows. Both you can use. But the Linux, many people, they use the Linux because for the reporting options, Windows is not supporting well. But the Linux will be using. Okay, I have modified in one place. See, whatever you modify, it will be changing immediately. It is saved. So I have changed the main block. See, have a look. This is your current OPAC. There is nothing in the middle. Now I'm just refreshing. I'll go to the home. Just click the home. See, under this, this is all I added now. See, EBSCO. This is my library. This is my library vision, mission, everything. So this is the way you can entirely modify the OPAC option also. I'm just going to edit the footer. There is nothing in the footer. I'm going to edit the footer. I have already written some small code we have to. OPAC credits. Go back. OPAC credits. You have to check one by one. This I will share it to you. This OPAC credits is a footer. See, footer is there. Now I'm going to edit the footer. There is nothing. I removed, I modified something. See the library, BUC. I will modify as a Tyagaraj College of Preceptors. Just Tyagaraj College I mentioned. Whether we will check whether it is changing or not. Save it. Come back. Just refresh. Click the home page. See, I have ordered two pages. Main block. This is called main block. I added. Footer. See, now I just added. Tyagarajar College. Email address. Copyright. Everything is changed. Here I will change as a copyright into 2020. Instead of email address, I will add just Madurai. Just I want to show you the. See, I changed. Now I'm going to refresh my page. Come down and check the footer. See, the copyright is changed to 2020 and Madurai. I removed the email ID. So this is what the footer. So you can modify everything according to your knowledge. So this is all, you know, small kind of HTML code. Even I don't know any HTML code. When I want to add the header, when I want to add the break or the color, I will check Google. See, I will show you just bold. If I want to make bold, HTML code. HTML code. See, this is what. Just click anything. It will show you how you can make the bold. Very small options. Just this one. Open. Whenever you make open, you have to close at the end. See, this is what simple you can learn. See, the same BR. Here we open, we have to end. End means close like this, a French slash. So this is small kind of tag you can easily learn from the Google. You can modify yourself. Okay, now I'm going to add on the left hand side. Are you guys are having time? I will just show you few more options so that
yes,
you
sir, please, sir.
Yeah, fine, thank you. And left hand side I'm going to add something else. Opaque header. See, opaque header. You can check by finding opaque header. Wherever you find this click option, you can edit. I'm going to remove everything, whatever they have. Remove. I modify. Here I mentioned the Library Biotechnology University College. It is my previous college. Now I change into Tyagarajar College of Preceptor, Madurai, Nigeria. I just mentioned. Okay, just I save it. We will see how it is working out. I saved it. Here I am going to, you know, this is the home page. I am just going to refresh. We will see. See it on the top. It is changed. Tyagarajar College of Preceptors, Madurai, Nigeria. And about these, all those things. Because here I have modified everything. So this is what? This is small link you can check in the Google HTML format. It is not a big coding options. Whatever you want to know, you can make it. Even this all you don't need. You need only the search box and footer is enough. The rest all will be taken easily. So this is the way you can modify one by one. I have a WAD file with me. I will close this sharing and I will open the new sharing. This is the WAD file I have for the Koha administration. This I used for my previous college that I took backup. This I will share it to you. Wherever the modifications we made, you can come back. See, this is what? Opaque user CSS. See, this is what the main page, the EBSCO you have seen, right? The EBSCO and my library policy, this is what. So this is what the footer I changed now. So this WAD file, I will share it to you. You can use it. You can modify by yourself. So it is very easy. Hope you can understand and how it is flexible. You all know, right? See, now you have the complete Koha. See, this is my complete library. Within 1 hour, I have designed. This is my library webpage. I have the collection in my library. Just select Indian library. Just go and search. See, this is what my library collection. I have ordered only 3 items. See? 2 books and 3 items. This is showing only in my library. This you can export in even Excel. Anything you can do it. For example, as a user, I log in into here. See, what is my login? Demo. Demo. Now I am a opaque user. This is my opaque page. As a user, see, welcome Dr. Sharma Prapoot. Now I can check my history. Go to your account. This is opaque completely as a user end. See, this is what my account. Hello, Dr. Sharma Prapoot. This is my checked out book. See, I have only one book. When is my fine? There is no fine. When the return date, everything is showing. When I took. See, this is what. If I want, I can renew myself. I can renew and here I can check everything. If I want, I can change my password. So what else we need? You have all the options. So can I close the Koha? So that's it. I have done. I have shown all the features to you and the session is going to be end. It has only 1 minute. If it is disconnected, you please rejoin and we will discuss about the this space within 2 seconds, and then we will share you the online quiz and the attendance and feedback link. Please, I request all the participants to joining back with the same link. I will finish it in 5 minutes. It's done already.